The International Space Station is the most fantastic vehicle ever built.
It's a one-of-a-kind laboratory orbiting about 250 miles above the Earth.
And we perform experiments on the International Space Station.
We can do science, we can do experiments, we can learn how to do things out of this world.
And the result will help benefit the people on the ground.
Space Station really provides an opportunity to explore, for example, say medical applications.
The aging and the osteoporosis and muscle wasting conditions are greatly accelerated in microgravity.
The weightless environment will give us insights into things like diabetes and maybe even cancer.
Understanding those phenomena allow us to look at how we can improve treatment of disease here on Earth.
If we wouldn't have conducted experiments on the ISS, we wouldn't have known that you could use cold atmospheric plasma in such broad application areas we're now exploring.
One of the most promising results has been gained by studying a protein associated with Duchenne muscular dystrophy.
We may be able to slow the disease by half, potentially doubling the lifespan of many of these DMD patients.
We provided ISERV imagery for many, many natural disasters, including floods and fires, for deforestations, for volcanic eruptions, and for earthquakes. So it was really a fantastic example showing how imagery from the International Space Station could be used in these times of dire need.
This was when we realized we had a chance to make a difference in the world using the same technology that was used by NASA, but applied in a remote area of a developing country.
I think it's made people much more aware of the issues of water quality. That's a very powerful thing.
Having the HICO on the International Space Station has been the ideal test bed for our research.
We can monitor these water bodies from space, and if we can reduce exposures both to humans and even animals, then we've achieved our goal.
And now today, we're able to operate the largest fleet of Earth imaging satellites in human history.
And none of that would have been possible without the International Space Station.
The space station has done so many things for life on planet Earth. It shows us what human beings can do working together. It shows the science that we can discover.
Over 2,000 experiments have flown on board ISS. 170 countries around the world have participated in some fashion, either in the ISS itself or in one of the experiments. Our rate of research is actually increasing. We're doing more today on board the space station for research than we have ever done before, and that's only going to continue in the future.
And so what we're seeing today is a proliferation of new ideas and new concepts. It's almost like it's a renaissance of what's happening in space. Buckle up and strap down, because this is going to be a rocket for all of us in the global community to be part of.